So good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Shubhankar Roy, a junior resident from Department of General of Medicine, IPHGMR, going to present an unusual case of Takayasu's arteritis. As we know, the Takayasu's arteritis is also known as the pulseless disease, is mainly a large vessel vasculitis. It preferentially affects the young females and mostly prevalent in the Japan, China, India, and Southeast Asia. It chiefly affects the aorta and its major branches. And ocular manifestations are usually less, though described overall in 8.1 to 68%, and mostly occurs in the course of the disease. In our case, a 27-year-old female without any prior comorbidities presented with bilateral painless progressive dimness of vision for 1 month. The dimness of vision has progressed to loss of vision gradually and sequentially, first in the right eye, followed by in the left eye, 11 and 5 days prior to the admission. There was no history of color desaturation or longitudinal field defect. The dimness of vision was associated with the frontal headache. There was no history of fever, focal neurologic deficit, no history of claudication, keratodynia. On examination, the mild pallor was present. Bilateral upper limb pulses were absent. Lower limb pulses were palpable. Pulse rate was 94 by minute. BP was unrecordable in bilateral upper limb. It was measured as 134 by 86 mmHg in left popliteal artery. However, no bruit was heard over any arterial territory. Rest of the general examination was within normal limit. On ocular examination, visual acuity, perception of light and projection of rays were lost in both eye. On fundus examination, it revealed macular edema, blurred disc, margin, disc edema, cherry red spot in both eye. Peripheral retina was within normal limit. It was diagnosed as bilateral central retinal artery occlusion by the ophthalmologist. Rest of the systemic examination was within normal limit. Now coming to the investigations, the blood examination revealed hemoglobin 10 gram per DL, ESR 36 millimeter in first hour. On suspecting vasculitis or underlying connective tissue disorder, we went for ANA, ANCA, and APLA, which are negative. C3, C4 were within normal limit. Serology was non-reactive. Lipid profile within normal limit. Serum homocysteine was within normal limit. Now, USG power Doppler studies of upper limb and subclavian area, subclavian arteries revealed dampened flow on power Doppler with perverse status pattern noted on spectral Doppler in bilateral subclavian, axillary, brachial, radial, and ulnar artery with significant luminal narrowing. Bilateral common carotid artery showed severe luminal narrowing with concentric wall thickening. CT angio was followed and it showed severe narrowing of brachiocephalic trunk and left common carotid artery as seen in the picture, as well as the complete occlusion of the origin of the left subclavian artery. There are no waveforms detected in the VP in the bilateral eye. The patient was diagnosed as Takayasu's arteritis as per ACR criteria. The treatment patient was started on IV pulse methylprednisolone 1 gram per day for 3 days, followed by 1 mg per kg dose prednisolone, along with acetazolamide to reduce the intraocular pressure, and the methotrexate as a secondary immunosuppression. However, after 2 weeks, there was no improvement of the vision, and thereafter, patient was lost to follow-up. Now, coming to the discussion, though we know that Takayasu's arteritis is majorly a large vessel vasculitis, this was a case of Takayasu's arteritis presenting with bilateral central retinal artery occlusion with loss of vision in the both eye. The present prevalence of the small retinal vessel involvement in Takayasu arteritis is unknown but very rare. On reviewing the literature, we found 7 cases of the BRAO and 2 cases of the BRVO were present as a small retinal vessel involvement in Takayasu's arteritis. Some of them were initial presentation, but however, no case was reported as presenting with bilateral CRAO as a presenting feature. So on concluding, the Takayasu's arteritis, though is a large vessel vasculitis, small vessel can be involved and retinal artery involvement can be first presenting feature. Thank you.